approximation of wood. All right. Got it going all the way under, all the way around the back there. That's not bad, you know? Okay, so our next step now is to highlight that just a touch. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that same color, if it's still, well, it's not even remotely still wet because this paint sucks. Okay, I'm going to make it again, adding, just pick up two or three brushfuls of this brown and add like a dot of black to it. Okay. All right, here we go. There we are. Good. Now let's put some water in it so it doesn't dry out as swiftly. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little of this yellow color, maybe half a brush full, and I'm going to add that in to the mixture. Okay. And that's going to give me... Actually, that's going to give me a color I don't really want. So we won't be using that. Sorry. Tell you what, let's use straight brown. Alright, how about that? That'll make it real easy. That would be a good color for the pouch once we get there, though, so I'll remember that color that I just mixed up. But for now, I'm just going to take the just straight-up brown and come in and lay in just a little bit of a highlight on what would be the top edge up here, if I can do it. Brush is not exactly conducive to edging on this model, but we'll make do. It's a challenge. Remember that. Okay? Just like that. Okay? Alright, so the top edge of that thing has been highlighted. Let's take a look at that again. Alright, really, really, really coming along. I'll be honest with you, I like it. So let's move on. And next, let's do the pouch at the back. Why not? Since we're already there anyway. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take basically the same color that we just used, so just that brown color, okay? And I'm going to come in and I'm going to put that in the pouch. All right. Let me see here. What would happen if I added a little green to that? Let's find out. I'd be interested to see if it darkens it up a lot or maybe a little bit or at all, you know? Not a lot. Nothing real dramatic there happens. So I'm going to leave that the way it is. I'm just going to go in with the regular brown color. Alright, put some of that on the palette, come right to the figure again, and here we go, just like this, just adding this color in. That's really, really, really bright for what I would prefer a pouch color to be. I would prefer a much more muted tone of brown, but it's not bad. Okay. Alright, so let's highlight that now. What I'm going to use for the highlight is the same color I just mixed, and thank God some of it is still wet. Alright. That color that I mixed was a couple of drops of the brown with a little tiny bit of yellow mixed in, alright? So I'm just going to come in here and just kind of hit in this area right here. And I need more yellow, I can tell already. Alright, so let me pick up some more yellow and mix that into the mixture here. Okay. Alright. There we go. That's good. Alright. Let me bring that highlight in now. Okay, there we go. That's better. Okay. Kind of get the outside edge of that little, the folds in the pouch there. Okay. And then bring that highlight down just a touch and around the front just a little bit, but I don't want to bring it all the way down to the bottom of the figure. Okay. You guys see that? You can see the streak in there for the highlight. I'm going to put in one little more drop of yellow and just see if we can pull that highlight out a little bit more, make it more visible. Just make it that much more interesting to look at. Okay? So, got another new highlight color here. And I'm just going to come right in, right in this area, right in here. Okay? And just pull that highlight down just like that. And then maybe do up here on the folds of the closure. Okay? Just like that. Real easy. Alright, let me put a little highlight right in that area there. Alright, cool. So, take a look at that right there. Not bad at all. Alright, so there's only two other areas on the miniature to do, the spear shaft and the spear head. Well, I guess you could count the wrappings as a third area. But, you know, for all practical purposes, this guy's pretty much done. But let's work next on the spear head itself. Okay, to paint the... We'll start off with the spear shaft. So to paint the spear shaft, I'm going to go with a dark brown color. All right, so I'm just going to pick up a little bit of black. All right, let's see here. Oh, where can I put it? Let's put it right here. I'm going to mix in a little bit of this brownish color here. All right, I actually kind of figured I would run out of paint before we got this far, but we haven't, thank God. All right, so... Right now it's kind of a dark gray, so let me try to mix in, what can I mix in? Maybe a little bit more brown, just to see if it'll work. Pop the brown open a little bit more, pick up another scoopful. Alright, and just mix it away. Okay, it's actually not bad. Put a little water in it, and just come right back to the figure once again. I can't tell if that's a... I think that's a white speck on the shoulder there. I'll have to come in and fix that. But, for right now, let's just work on the spear shaft. Be very gentle here. Okay. I don't want to overdo things at all. Okay, just very gently and very carefully painting in each of these areas. Now, obviously... I didn't mention this up front, but I went ahead and cleaned all the mold lines off this figure and everything like that, so we don't have to worry about those, just in case you thought I'd taken it right out of the package and just placed it onto the base. I would never do that. Never, ever, ever. Always want to make sure that you clean your mold lines off your figures. Okay? Now, the box of the Battle for Skulls Pass paint set shows this particular area of the miniature as a red spear shaft. And you could do that if you wanted to. I think it looks more natural if you do it in a wood color. So that's what we're doing. Alright. And just like this. Spear shaft. Looks like wood. Alright, you guys see that? Focus! I swear, if it doesn't focus, I think it's because my finger's in the way. There we go. Look at that. My knuckle was in the shot. Okay, let's pull that out just a little. There we go. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. You see how that looks like wood? Okay. What I'm going to do to highlight that is come in and add in just a bit more of the brown color. Okay, so just a touch. Just a bit more. All right. Okay, and I'm going to... Just kind of wipe the brush off just a little bit, all right, and come in and just sort of kind of fake dry brush at this point. Well, actually, it's kind of, that area is still kind of wet. So I'll tell you what I'll do. While I'm waiting on that to dry, let me grab a drop of this black paint and come in and fix this shoulder. I don't know why that's white, but hey, that's okay. We can fix it. No big deal. And let's come in and paint the... Well, no, we can do that in a few moments. Let's see. Well, I guess, yeah, why not? Let's do it. Let's go wild, all right? Let's go ahead and paint the wrappings on the spear handle. Okay, I'm going to just paint those in brown. All right, we're going to paint them basically the same way we painted the pouch over on the side. But... Maybe not highlight them quite as much, or maybe highlight them, you know, even more. It kind of all hinges on how the spear shaft turns out, okay? Because we're gonna be having basically three areas: one, the spear shaft; two, the wrappings; and three, the spear head itself, that are essentially going to be the same color. All right, for the spear shaft or the spear head. We're going to have to add brown to our mixture to come up with highlights that's going to look like rock, okay? So, the spear head and the spear shaft are going to be very, very similar in color. So, what we don't want is we don't want the wrappings to be similar to both of those, because then it'll look like we just kind of halfway did it, and it's not going to look very nice.